Good evening, everybody. Selamun aleyküm. Hope you can listen to me, hear me, and then see me. Thank you so much for attending our information session about the Division of Sustainable Development and our Master and PhD programs. I just would like to wait a couple more minutes, if you don't mind, for people to come from the other session. So please bear with us for another couple minutes. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Muammar, Dr. Yusuf. So I think perhaps if you wish, you can start the presentation now, because the info session, the general one, has completed now. And I think we have around 15 attendees with us. So the floor is yours. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Izzettin. We just told them we will start at 5:50.
Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Muammar. How are you doing? I think you can start if you wish. The floor is yours. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Thanks for joining us. Assalamu alaikum. I will just give a brief presentation about the Division of Sustainable Development and the Master and then through the Q&A box, we can receive your questions and we will try to answer them as much as possible. So let me introduce myself. My name is Muammer Koç. I am the founding professor and head of the Division of Sustainable Development. And the best way to reach me is through email if you have any other questions. Thank you. I am sure pretty much all of you are aware of the sustainability, the needs for sustainability, and what's going on in the world around sustainability and sustainable development goals. But this is the fundamental concept and the paradigm that we designed and we built our division, our academic programs around it. So basically meeting the needs of today, our generation without compromising the ability of our future generations, our children, their children to meet their own needs is the fundamental definition, description of sustainability and sustainable development. As you all may know, it is one of the global paradigms accepted, promoted by the United Nations under the SDGs, Sustainable Development Goals. It is also the underlying fact and the vision of the Qatar National Vision. In our division, we have two main streams of academic programs. Although they are very close to each other, there are many overlaps between each other. One of them is concentrating on sustainable energy, and the other one is sustainable environment. For both, we have PhD and master programs. And we started both of these programs in 2015, so it has been 6 years, and with about 10 faculty members. Currently, we offer around 25 courses in 2 semesters every year, and pretty much we have a steady state number of 80 graduate students in our programs, a mix of masters and PhDs, locals and international. Males and females, it is about 80 students. It can go up a little bit or go down, but this is pretty much the steady state. And thus far, we have graduated more than 90 students from our programs. Around 30 of them are PhD graduates and 60 are from the master programs. And all of them, they completed dissertations and theses. And they work on different research projects during their tenure in the program. And as a result of their studies, their research, our faculty and our students and graduates so far published more than 450 publications, journal papers, conference papers, books and chapters. So we hope that you will join us. You will be one of the students in our program. And you will join us to make this similar publications and research, conduct research under the advisory of different faculty members. In the sustainable energy program, we have faculty members and students, master's PhD students, focusing on renewable energy, energy storage, some focusing on oil and gas technologies. We have faculty members focusing on and conducting research in mobility, smart cities, transportation, energy production, conversion, and different transmission technologies, such as smart grid, and sustainable manufacturing, sustainable green buildings, and overall emission reductions through in the energy production, conversion, and transmission technologies. In the environment, our faculty research mainly focus on waste to product, water, water dissemination, water management, water treatment, urban planning, built environment, ecosystem management, air quality, and food. Of course, there are many other areas of research. I'm just listing some of them here. along with the faculty members, core faculty members in our division. I hope you can visit their websites and learn more about them. And you are welcome to contact them and ask them questions about their research and teaching. When it comes to the program details, once you are in the program, for master's students, we have three core courses that all master's and PhD students, in fact, they have to take. The three core courses, I will mention them to you later. In master's, in addition to the three core courses, you also need to take five electives and join the seminars in the fall semesters and also conduct research for your thesis. So it is totally 33 credits and approximately it takes about 2 years, four semesters. But we had students who completed it in a shorter time, like three semesters. Also, we have students completed in a longer time. For the PhD, the course requirements are less, three core and three electives. And the seminars are same. You have to take the seminars in the fall semesters at least three times. And PhD is mainly a research-based study. Its research component is higher, about 36 credits. So you need to conduct a dissertation research with an advisor. And it is minimum 54 credits, and it is taking about 4 years. In the past, we had students, they completed it in 3 years, but it is quite unusual. Most of our students, they completed in 4 years, 8 semesters. Core courses are three, as I mentioned to you. In the fall semester, when you first join us, we have research methods and we have the sustainable fundamentals. These two courses are taken by all students. And then in the spring semester, you need to take one more core course. And you can choose one of the courses listed here. They are all around the quantitative skills, statistics, math, data analytics, etc. But you can also take courses from other divisions if they are approved by your advisor, and you need to go through an approval process. Then you will also register into the seminars and register in the research. And these are the selection of the elective courses, mostly offered in the fall semester. As you can see, the variety is quite large. Some of them are related to energy, some are environment. And in the spring semester, spring semester, we have additional core courses, elective courses. And you can also take electives from other divisions, other colleges, in limited numbers. Like master students can take two electives from other divisions or colleges, while PhD students can take only one of them from outside. We have a good amount of research facilities in the building that we are housed in the LAS building of Penrose. But in addition to our core facilities, we have also access to the HBKU-wide Research Institute laboratories in the North Campus. And I am sure our colleagues in the previous session went through the admission requirements. I don't need to go over them now, but I would like to get your questions if you have any. And here I can read one question from one of the attendees. I can read it for you. Basically, he is asking that I have submitted my application since November, but I have not received any decision yet. That's right. We have not finalized the selection process yet. In a couple of weeks, we are going to go over the first batch of applications and then make a selection. And if you are admitted, then you will be contacted. In fact, even before the admission, some faculty members may contact you for interviews. And after the interviews, if any of the faculty member considers you for his or her research group, then you will be admitted, and then you will be contacted by the admission office. This process may take until the beginning of or the middle of March. So please be patient until then. Okay, I have, is there any research on charging improvement of electric cars? Yes, there are faculty members. They are working on electric vehicles, electric vehicle charging, and different technologies and economics aspects of it. I am a graduate of mechanical engineering with 5 years of mechanical design experience. Am I a good candidate for sustainable energy department? Yes, basically, as you can see from the admission requirements, I'll just go to this page so you can look at it while I am talking. We accept pretty much all fields of engineering and science, in addition to business, economics, finance, some social studies, as long as your academic credentials are competitive. We, as you know, we have the limit, the minimum limits for master's and PhD. You have to have minimum 3.0 GPA, okay? And then you need to also demonstrate your English skills using through different English examinations such as TOEFL, IELTS. If you are applying for a PhD, you must have a master's degree, and also you must present a GRE score. And the selection process, admission for admission, is purely based on merit, your academic credentials. All applications. And if one of the faculty members contacts you, interviews you, and then chooses you for his or her research group, then you can be admitted. So there is no limit pretty much to any discipline, but the limit comes from the academic credentials. Is there a minimum GRE score for PhD application? Yes. We only consider a GRE quantitative, the math section, and we are requiring a minimum of around 160. But also it depends on the other applicants' GRE and other academic credentials. At the end of the day, it is a ranking process. If we have 20 applicants, for example, with high GRE scores, high GPAs, and if you are in the 21 or the 25th, of course, the priority will may be given to the others, depending on the faculty's research considerations. So 160, around 160 is the minimum for the PhD. What type of scholarships do you offer? There are basically two types of scholarships, although their content may change this year. We don't know yet. It depends on the latest budget figures that they will receive. I can tell you what was the scholarship last year. For working people, if you are working full-time, it means you are in Qatar already, you will be considered only for tuition reduction. It is about 80% reduction. So you end up with paying 20% of the tuition. And this is for the working people. And if you are an international student, or if you are not working but living in Qatar with academic good academic credentials, etc., and if you are chosen by one of the faculty members for the research, then in addition to the tuition reduction, you are also given a stipend. And if you are coming from another country, you are given annual tickets and housing. And the stipend with the housing is pretty much very competitive. And so that you just concentrate on your studies, you don't need to worry about anything else. Does the sustainable economy cover the business side of renewable energy? Yes, definitely. We have students, in fact, working on renewable energy, but there it's economic aspects of it, or financial aspects of it. So we have that kind of resource stream. For masters especially, you don't need to have research experience. It is better to have research experience, but you don't need to. It all depends on, as I told you before, your academic credentials, your GPA, your GRE, your TOEFL, or IELTS scores will determine whether you are, whether you can be admitted or not. And of course, the interview that the faculty member, one of them may contact and conduct, is another factor in the selection admission process. Yes, we have another question is about computer engineering, whether they can be considered for sustainable energy. Yes, of course, you can be considered as the list you can find here. We accept students from computer engineering too. There are some private specific questions. I'm sorry, I cannot help you with these login details. You need to contact the admission office. As the faculties, we cannot do anything and we have no access to that. Is there any way that you can get our publications? Yes, of course, our all publications are open in the web, on the internet. You can make a Google search and you will get most of them, if not all of them. Any other questions? I believe I answered all the questions written here so far. Timing of the classes, good question. Our classes start at 4 p.m. every day. So 4 to 7 o'clock is one block of course. The courses are conducted as a block, 3 hours, starting at 4 p.m. and ending at usually 7 p.m., depending on how many breaks and how long breaks given to you. What is the expectation of the faculty from the applicant if interviewed? Basically, they will contact you based on your academic credentials, your the materials that you uploaded, supplied to us, your transcript, your GRE, your TOEFL scores, etc., or your research experience. And if they are interested in what you supplied to us, basically, they can go over your CV with you, ask you additional questions about your CV to learn exactly what you did in your studies, in your research. Some of them, they can go into details about specific courses you take, or if you accomplish any research papers, they can ask you about this. They will just try to learn more about you, to see whether you are a good fit for the research or not. That's the bottom line. So you just need to be open, you know, frank and transparent, tell them exactly who you are, what you are, and that should do it easy and straightforward. Is there any work arrangement for student with only tuition waiver? Yes, there are some student assistant or student work programs, not necessarily within the division, but across the university. And but this is something that you need to apply for each of the application, and then you need to be selected for it. So there is no guarantee from the our college, our division, for you to be considered for this kind of additional student work opportunities. But there are many options for that. But usually they start hiring students in their second year. At least they need to be in their second semester. Is there funding for master students from abroad? Yes, again, if you are selected by a faculty member for the research, it means wherever you are from, they will extend their support for you for the stipend. That's possible. Is this session recorded? I believe so. I think so. We need to check with the people who arrange it, but I think so. Are the courses more theoretical based or will they be industrial project? Both. We have courses. They are pretty much theoretical. As you can imagine, there's quantitative courses, math, statistics, etc. But we also have many applied industrial related courses too. If I have a master already in engineering power systems, can I apply for master? Yes, if you want to apply for master again, you can, but you can also apply for PhD too. If a student is not admitted, if he is allowed to talk to a professor on a relevant work. Of course, you can talk even now without making an application as a somebody from outside, as a citizen, as a resident. You can always contact any of the faculty members and talk to them if they are interested in or if they have time. You just need to send them an email, introduce yourself, and ask your question. I am sure many of them will be very happy to answer as much as they can. You don't need to wait for this to be admitted or not admitted. You can do it anytime. Which has more value for my application for master's program? Published research papers or industrial experience? Both are important, definitely, but when it comes to the selection process, I think most of the faculty members, they prefer having a candidate with a proven record of research, publications, etc., other than their industrial experience, because that's something demonstrable. If a student has already some innovations to environmental remedy, would the university support him with laboratory equipment to test them? It really depends. I cannot tell you yes or no. First of all, you need to be admitted to the program, and then you need to discuss this with your advisor. If he or she agrees with your innovation, if it is something useful, then with advisor support, of course, you can make it into a research and laboratory work. That's possible. In addition to the research, we also have HPKU Innovation Center, which also provides funding for HPKU students to prototype their innovative ideas. That's another avenue you can try. But we don't provide such funding or open our labs for to people from outside. Okay. Please advise what type of research work is going in urban mobility. Which one? I mean, urban mobility or urban air quality? If urban air quality, we have many people, couple faculty members, who are basically measuring the air quality, urban mobility, sorry, you are talking urban mobility. For urban mobility, we look at it from the urban design, built environment perspective, as well as from the sustainable transportation perspective to minimize the time spent on the roads, from point A to point B, and then we also do try to analyze how to minimize the emissions coming from the traffic in a given like setting, like Doha, for example. And there is another approach to it, which looks at it from the modeling approach. And for this, we use system dynamics and agent-based modeling. Okay. Okay, no other questions. How to contact professors? Basically, just emails in the web pages. They have their email addresses in the HBKU web page. You can just send an email from there, any of them. Curriculum slide, sure. I can go back. Okay, so these are the, let me start from here. For masters, 8 courses totally, 3 core and 5 electives and research thesis. For PhD, 6 courses totally, 3 core courses and 3 electives and research. These are the core courses that every student must take. In fall, we have the research methods and sustainability fundamentals. In spring, you choose one of these, either stat or math, data analytics, numerical methods, optimization, or there are some other relevant quantitative courses from other divisions. You can select them too with approvals. Then you take the seminar and the research credits, and these are the electives, mostly offered in the fall semester. Okay, I can wait for you to go over it a little bit, or you can take a picture of it. As you can see, they are related to energy, environment. Some are theoretical, some are applicable into the industry. These are the courses in the spring. I need to change this. They use the wrong name. These are the spring electives usually. And whenever your research requires you to take a specific course, and if it is not offered in the division, as I told you, you can go and check if other divisions or other colleges are offering. We allow that. It is limited to one or two. But even if in case you don't find it in the HBKU, not offered in another college, then your advisor or another faculty member can design an independent study for you to help you to focus on learning a specific subject that will be helpful for your research too. So our curriculum is quite flexible, and it is not heavy, I would say, compared to other typical programs, and it is mainly research oriented. And these are the labs. Okay. Thank you so much for your time, for your attendance, and we hope to have your applications as soon as possible before the deadlines. And just wait for a faculty member to contact you for their interviews. And then hopefully by the mid-March, you will hear from us latest about whether you are admitted or not. Thank you, and have a nice evening.